From New York City, where a diamond hard surface of glitter and froth hides a pulsing miasma of heartbreak and shame. From New York City, where armed debutantes hold the middle classes at bay. From New York City, where trust is just a name on a bank, comes the man who can't keep a secret, Mr. Chatterbox, and his gossip report to the nation.
This is Mr. Chatterbox reporting to you from the frontiers of fashion where chic never sleeps. Sassing back, that's right, giving lip to mom and dad is the latest show's affair. Tani Consuelo Drudoff sasses her dad while he shaves, chuckles when he nicks himself, couldn't like it more. Angelita Ramos Ramos, daughter of the famed Brazilian tap dancer, gets her way by threatening to turn dad over to the immigration men. Never better, but no one tops plucky Trisha Nixon. Trisha cusses her pa in Spanish, badmouths his puffy jowls, then holds her breath till she, well, upchucks. It's nasty, but it works, and Mr. Chatterbox couldn't like it more. Smart socialites are dumping nouns using fabulous descriptive adverbs instead. Honestly and truly, says Gotham's Mrs. Latham Lothrop, I'm getting so I can't order a drink without an adverb. It all goes to show just how cooperative and useful our own English language can be, don't you think? Or don't you? You had to be pretty dumb to fall for that lavender marmalade hype, but I'm afraid you still run into the purple muck at Merle Oberon's. Someone ought to tell Merle that tests conducted by Trobeard, top New York public relations firm, show that lavender marmalade in large doses can cause cancer of the guest list. I don't mean to be hard on you, Merle, dear, but Mr. Chatterbox knows best. Peppy Ethel Kennedy, who loves the little ones, is writing a children's book in Fortran. Aristocratic Ethel's family includes dozens of third-generation computers, which is something you ought to remember. Stand-up comic Billy Bison is the latest showbiz personality to take the plunge of the avocado baths. The avocado baths, in case you don't know, are where certain of our young men go to meet vegetables. It's the most about perverse, but Billy Bison will do anything for a laugh. Swatty-sans socialites in the make are renting Mamie Eisenhower, that's right, by the day, by the hour, by the yard. Dick Nixon's done it for years, pays a pretty penny, too. 1,000 clams gets you away for the photographer, 10,000, and she'll stand at a reception line up the Addie some more, and you can celebrate Mamie's birthday. She has 3 or 4 a year, but no amount of money can get her to open her trap. I shouldn't have told you that, but Mr. Chatterbox thought you ought to know. Wayne Newton's countersuing Anne Margaret. Winsome Wayne claims Anne's taste in clothes drove him to sleeping pills. No one knows for sure what Mrs. Adolfo Stewart is tattooing on her forehead, but rumor has it it's a map of her hometown of Scottsdale, Arizona. Mrs. Adolfo Stewart is the most amount loyal. Also the most amount boring, but Mr. Chatterbox knows when to hold his tongue. St. Paul and Minneapolis, still the Twin Cities. Dust Kitty, still the housemaid's hobgoblin. Georges Pompidou, still a stupid ass. This is Mr. Chatterbox signing off. Do try to mix with a better class of people, won't you? And you, Miss Helen Hayes, it's time you got married, don't you think? Or don't you?
Clippity-clap, clippity-clippity-clippity-clippity-clippity-clippity-clap and along. Und now no good no more nana, und no good yanda. Ulama, unna, ya to wanda. Yina, unna, unna, gina, no ya pongo, no, yo, mando. Luchi! Hey, hey! una, oh, sushi alabama, una, uno. Hey, what's the matter, go mule? Holy semen, go clippity clap for Blanky Lane. Holy semen, go clippity clap, clap, chop, chop for Blink Crosby. Holy semen, go chop, chop, chop for Van Malone. Holy semen, go for Guy Lombardo. You fool, you mule, you fool. Hold on, hold on, hold on. There's a plug of chaw tobacco for a miner in Kelowna, a guitar for a cowboy way out in Arizona, a glass of calico for a split in Navajo. Get a la home, mule! Get a la home, luchi! Hola! Liberty clap and over heel and flame. Seems as how they never stop. Liberty clap got little telescopes and keychains. Whole picture knock your eye out. A Korean fella who gonna have a tryout. A week from Sunday night with Mr. Holy Height. Get a load. Oh, the flogging throw. He better take slow more for China. You, Blanky Lane, Bleak Claudy, Von Monroe, Tennessee Ernie, or Luchi. Hola, una, 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 una.
How can I really know if I'm a humorous person or an average run-of-the-mill I-don't-get-it type? Well, it's often better to find out if you're funny in the privacy of your own home first. Right now, unplug your radio and take it into the bathroom with you. We'll give you 5 seconds to get there. Are you there? Good. Plug the radio in and stand in front of your bathroom mirror. Don't be embarrassed. You're all alone. Simply follow instructions. Now, insert the pinky fingers of your left and right hands, respectively, into the left and right corners of your mouth, like so. Pull hard so that your lips peel back and you can see your teeth. Are you looking at yourself in the mirror? Is it funny? You've probably started chuckling already, haven't you? A good sign. Let's hurry while we have the moment and move right on to the shtick test. Okay, now, still keeping one finger in your mouth, take your other hand and remove the top from the jar of Vaseline on the shelf below your mirror. Ordinary toothpaste or shaving cream will do. Spread some on your left cheek and in your hair. Pretty funny, huh? If you're not already laughing, try drooling or spitting up on yourself a bit and wiping it into your shirt. The shoulder is always a funny place to do this. While you are laughing, immediately remove the other finger from your mouth and change instantly into a serious expression. And, while looking right into your reflection, say the words moose poop or poopay. You're sure to crack yourself up. Here comes the final and most important test to help you find out if you indeed have a sense of humor. Open the cabinet and remove the blade from your razor. Close the cabinet and stare at your face briefly. No smiling or cracking up. Now, quickly, just as fast as you can, slit your left wrist, taking care not to cut the tendons. Only the blood vessels should be severed. Repeat with your right wrist. Okay? Now, if you thought I was serious about slitting your wrists, you blew it. And clearly you don't have a sense of humor at all. If, however, you thought I was only kidding, you're right. And now,
the winning poem from the National Lampoon's National Poetry Writing Contest. As you may remember, contestants were asked to write a 9-line love poem in perfect meter, with every line ending with the word hill. Entries were judged on the basis of originality and sensitivity. Here now, to personally read you his winning poem, is first prize winner John Jacobly from Erie, Pennsylvania.
On the Hill, by me, John Jacobly. There I saw her on the hill, with another boy beside her on the hill. Behind them the sun was setting behind the hill, and he kissed her while a lark sung on the hill. My heart was breaking as I watched the hill, and then I saw them start to come down the hill. Locked arm in arm, they came down the hill, and I'll never forget when I stood on that hill, and watched the girl I loved and the guy she loved holding hands and coming down the hill.
You are listening to the National Lampoon Radio Hour.